Hey, hey. Do y'all want to dance? Everybody, all aboard. Talk to y'all. How are you today? I'm coming to you. First of all, this week I'm going to have like the ice cream style cannolis coming at you. Bam! No fat, raw, vegan. You can eat the whole container and still fit your pants, you know, and still feel like dancing, which is the point. I'm coming to you today. First of all, this Friday, it will be very exciting because the votes are in on your favorite hot raw chef. Come on, Tanny, come on! And if we win, we're going to be announcing that all around this town. And Chris was like, oh my gosh. He will be on board for the fun. So I want to come and talk to you about this. You know, what is it that you want? That's the bottom line. What is it that you want? Not what sounds good that you should want or what somebody else wants. What is it you want? You know, I think a lot of times we just can't pick. We don't go with our gut instinct and we just kind of flounder around until that feeling is gone, you know, and we just become complacent in the same dang thing we do every day, never creating the life for ourselves that we want, you know? I mean, do you want to do this diet and lifestyle because you want to lose weight? Do you want to cure your diabetes with diet and not drugs, which just put a Band-Aid on it? You want mental clarity? Do you want better fluid dance moves? I don't know. What is it that you want? What's your why is my question of the day. You know, it's not just this broad thing that's going to be okay for everybody to hear you say, well, you know, I just want to get healthy. Why do you want to get healthy, you know? I mean, pinpoint it like, I want to get healthy because I don't feel like getting down on the floor and playing with my kids. And frankly, they get on my nerves because I feel like crap. I don't feel like my husband touching me and carrying on because I don't feel good about myself. How about you're a man? I want to get rid of these man boobs because I want to hook up with some cute girl. Get down to the nitty-gritty reality. It's not my job to judge your why. It's your job to figure out the why you want to do it, you know? I mean, you can get the information. The information is out there, you know. There's books you can read. There's people you can follow. And nowadays, you know, there's people you can follow that have done it and have solid results. What is the problem? You can Google it, you know? You can cyber stalk people that have gotten the results you want and actually follow what they eat in a day, right? It's free tools, you know? But the thing is, we're stuck in that thing where, you know, it's that word, fine. How are you today? I'm fine. How are you? Fine. Why don't people really say how they feel? Are you dragging around an extra 50, 60, 70 pounds with you every day? Is that fine? No, it's not fine. You know, you're dragging all that weight around, but you're fine. That's what you say. I'm fine. How are you? You hate your job, you know? You can't stand to be around your spouse. You don't even love or touch each other anymore or talk or really care what the other person's doing. You coexist as roommates, you know, but that's fine. You know, saying I'm fine is a cheap out. It gets you out of having to do anything about what you're currently doing. If you're fine, then it's okay that you're carrying around 50 pounds of saddlebags on your legs, or worse than that, around your chest and middle, going to cause you to have a heart attack, right? That's not fine. But it keeps you from having to do anything about it. I mean, if you feel crappy today, say, I'm crappy today. Other people aren't going to care, but guess who's going to hear that? You. And maybe you'll decide that that's not fine. you know, or if you're having an awesome day and somebody asks you how you are, I'm having an awesome earthly experience. I don't know what you want to say, but something other than I'm fine is such a neutral ground that we just don't care about how we feel anymore, you know? The biggest problem with saying fine to others is, you know, you hear that yourself. You've convinced yourself you're fine in these areas of your life, you know? I mean, it's like it's too hard to have a conversation with your parents that they could actually change their lifestyle, but well, they don't want to change. It's fine. Or, you know, I don't know. All you can do is try. I know you can't change the world, but you can stand up and speak up sometimes. I mean, I want to remind y'all this. I heard somebody say one time that, you know, the odds of us being born, you know, to, with our DNA, to the parents we were born to, in the very moment in time we were, with all our specific characteristics and everything else, is 1 in 400 trillion. I mean, you're here on this earth for a reason, and it's not just to be fine. It's not just to push it under the rug, and you grew up and you want to get in your lifestyle and you're not happy with your life and you're not, but it's fine. It's the only life we have, you know? Don't you want to shine? I mean, you're not just fine. You're fantastic, you know? No one can be you. 1 in 400 trillion. All day long we've got ideas, you know, that can change the world and that can change us and change our life. But you know what we do? We do nothing because we're fine, you know? Have you ever been somewhere like on a cruise ship or somewhere and they started some music and everybody was up to dance or there was like a swim party and you were on the sidelines and you didn't get in because you were fine. You didn't get up to dance because you were fine. Though in that split second you wanted to do it, it was your gut instinct to jump up and do it, but you didn't do it. And it passed you by because you were fine. You could have been fantastic. You could have embraced that about yourself, you know? I mean, what about is your first intuition and decision in the morning to hit the snooze? Bam, bam, on and on. That's how you're going to start your day. It's like the activation energy that when that clock goes off, you can throw the covers back, get the heck out of the bed even earlier than normal, and get your day started differently tomorrow than you did today. Differently today than yesterday. Start this minute. It's an activation energy that if you don't take it at that moment, it's gone. And all these split seconds turn into minutes and moments, and that becomes our life, our lifestyle, and our lifetime that we had. We didn't take and get on with the activation energy that we have coming out of us. You feel it sometimes, but yet you hit the snooze because you're fine, you know? People don't feel like changing their patterns, you know? But when you start your day off different, just like jumping out of the bed, you could catapult yourself, your day, into a whole different direction, manifesting a different you. Don't y'all think? That's exciting, you know? Are we waiting in this world until we feel like it? Guess what? You're not going to feel like changing your patterns. You're not going to feel like getting up out of the bed instead of laying there 30 more minutes and... let's even say like doing something a little more to yourself, sprucing yourself up. Guess what day you're going to have when you feel more confident and prettier and just like you got yourself together? A better day. What about when you get up and rebound and you have energized yourself from the top to bottom, inside out? You will feel that energy busting out of your cells. What kind of day are you going to have? It won't just be fine. You see? I mean, our body is wired with these signals. If we'll listen to them, you know, we can make a difference for ourselves, you know? Feeling stuck and dissatisfied with your life, you know, it's a signal that something in your life is broken, that you're not fine. Something's not being met, you know. You're not reaching your full potential. If you're going around saying you're just fine, you're not reaching your full potential. Your full authentic self that only you can be, 1 in 400 trillion are the odds that you would be you. Y'all like that? So I'm fixing to go out and do some errands, and I'll be out and about, and I will not be out just being fine. It'll be an extraordinary day in an ordinary world, you know? Because I am always on the party train.